Hi YouTubers, welcome to my channel. This is the first time I have ever done a YouTube review or left any kind of video on my YouTube channel. I don't normally leave videos. I normally look at other people's videos and pre. So this is the first time for me, so bear with me. But I'll get to the point. I purchased a full lace wig from Glamour House of Hair. A couple years ago I purchased from them a lovely wig from them, and it lasted me about 2 years with frequent use. So I thought I'd purchase another one. They've got some gorgeous hairstyles and textures on their website, and what I purchased was a 20-inch Allure natural colour full lace wig. There was no combs in the back or the side. It was just full lace, full lace unit to be sewn down. That was the purpose. I purchased the wig in October, and then after I purchased the wig, I was waiting a couple of weeks, and I emailed them asking them for an ETA on my order. And the lady had said that it's not going to be coming until, it's going to come in two months. And that was the first thing I was a bit annoyed about, because before I had ordered, pre-ordering, the lady was going back and forth. I was going back and forth with the lady, talking about the hair, the style, the length, the measurements. And she told me it was going to be 4 weeks. Okay, so I was really pissed off about this, because I wanted to actually wear the wear over the Christmas holidays. So I couldn't. They did offer, I think they did say that I could cancel, but because I'd already waited several weeks, I thought, you know what, I'll change my style for the holidays. I'll wear something else, and I'll just go ahead with the order. So the wig never arrived in the UK until the end of December, I think, given that it was, it took 2 months. They said they were sourcing the hair and it's going to take 2 months. And then it was the Christmas holidays, so sometimes the post is a bit messed up. So there you go. The wig arrived. When the wig had arrived, I wasn't ready to install the unit, because I was ready rocking something else, and I just wasn't ready to wear it. In fact, I was going to leave it until July of this year for the summer, because I'm going on holiday. I thought I'd rock it then. But no, I thought, okay, February came, and I thought I would probably get it installed. I'm going out for Valentine's weekend. I'll have it installed over the weekend. So I booked my appointment for the 18th of February, which was last Saturday. And in the week, I took the unit down to the salon to ask them to customise the front. You can't really see, but to customise the front and just have it there while I before I come for my my appointment. I noticed, as you can see from the photos, that the knots on the wig was not bleached. On the 14th of February, I emailed Glamour House of Hair and I said, look, you know, I requested for the wig to be bleached knots. It's not, as you can see from the pictures, it's clearly not. And then the lady or the person came back and said, we did request for your knots to be bleached, but it's never guaranteed. Now, my thing with that is, if it's not guaranteed, you should stipulate that during the ordering process. And I did say that, I said that that was never stipulated during my customer journey when I was ordering. And it should have, something that should be mentioned, because the customer has an expectation and you're not fulfilling the expectation. You're selling it as if it can be fulfilled, but it's actually not guaranteed. So that was, I was really annoyed with that. When we came to fit the wig, the one good thing about the wig is it's a perfect fit. I gave them my measurements, and I've got a small head anyway, and it was a perfect fit. You don't need to sew it down or clip it down or anything. I don't need combs, I don't need straps. It is literally a perfect fit, very snug. So I went to fit the wig, and then what we did was just, I just sprayed it, well, the lady, the salon, the stylist sprayed it down with some cold water, so just conditioner and water. She just sprayed it down, and it didn't look great, but it looked okay, and I thought to myself, I'm going out this evening, so we don't really need to over-style it now. I know what to do when I get in. Anyway, I got in on Saturday night. I actually got in the shower and actually just wet the hair completely with water because it had already been co-washed, and plus we used conditioner on it. So I thought, I don't want to over-put too much product in it because too much conditioner can weigh the curls down, can weigh the hair down. So I did that, and then I let it air dry a bit, and I went out. Sunday, I sprayed it down with some conditioner again, and Monday I'm at work, and I'm looking at this hair, and I'm thinking, it's just a mess. I mean, the ends are terrible, as you can see. This hair doesn't look like I've just installed a new lace unit. This hair looks like I've been wearing it for weeks or even for months. The ends are just terrible. And I fully appreciate that the end of the hair, you can see, in fact, I fully appreciate that the ends of the hair, but there you go, is the oldest part of the hair. But that doesn't mean that the quality of the hair should be compromised. I'm a hair fiend. I buy hair all the time. All the time. And I've had really bad hair. But normally the bad hair starts to show weeks into wearing it. I've never installed any type of hair. I've never fitted a lace wig. And the hair looks like this after 3 days. Look at that. It's just disgusting. And I'm very hair proud, and it's just a mess, really. So this evening, I emailed Glamour House of Hair. I sent them a long-winded email, but very to the point. And I will wait for them to respond. There's nothing they can really do. I'm sure they're not going to offer me a refund. I'm sure they're not going to do it. And that's not what I'm looking for, to be honest. I spent over $500 US. And to me, that might be a lot for some people. That's a budget I would spend on hair. But not hair that looks like this after 3 days. It looks like dreadlocks. I mean, I guess it looks like someone's natural hair who doesn't condition their hair. But look at this. It's terrible. It's just disgusting. Very, very, very disappointing. The ends shouldn't look like this. I'm going to have to actually get my stylist to just trim the ends. Probably take about an inch off. Probably take an inch off. Look at that. This is after 3 days. And what I would like, if anyone does watch this review, I would really, really, really appreciate if someone could perhaps suggest what I could do to salvage this hair. I've got silicone mixed conditioner. Perhaps I could just use that on it. But again, for a unit, any hair or unit that you spend $500 plus on, this is terrible. This is terrible. If I didn't have something else to wear, then I'd just take it straight out. I'm really, really disappointed. It's a waste of money. And I actually recommend Glamour House of Hair to my friends. Not many people would spend that kind of money on hair anyway, but it was, Glamour House of Hair was in my top 5 list of suppliers. So that's it. It's really disappointing. Like I said, the good thing about it was the actual cap was amazing. I've never gone for a cap without any straps or without any without any straps or any combs, maybe a couple years ago. But this just fitted like a glove on my head. The cap construction was on point. But the hair, man, I'm just pissed. I'm well pissed. And like I said, I'm a person that changes her hair every 3 to 4 weeks. I purchase hair at least every quarter. Every quarter. So, you know, I know about hair. I'm not a novice. I'm not a newbie, you know. But it's really disappointing. Very disappointing. Anyway, run over. Again, I would really appreciate any suggestions of what I can do. Really, or specific brands of products I should use. I've got everything, so I'm sure I'll be able to find something. I can find most things on the web, or just please, I'd be very happy and grateful if someone could tell me what products I could use on this mess. I mean, some people probably say it's not that bad, but after 3 days, it looks like this. What's going to happen after a week? Nah. It's unacceptable. It's really, really disappointing. Anyway, thank you. Over and out.